How do the modern DRAKON flowcharts differ from the traditional flowcharts? DRAKON flowcharts have a strict order. The start of the DRAKON flowchart is always located at the top of the diagram, in its header. The header contains the name of the diagram. The end of the diagram is always at the bottom of the diagram. There is only one end icon. The end icon must contain the word end. This is the skewer. We will build the body of the algorithm on it. There are several ways in which we can add an icon to the diagram. First, click the button in the toolbox. Then, click the yellow circle. Here is another way. Right-click the skewer and choose the icon type. But the best way is to use shortcuts. To add an action icon, press the A key. Let's create a simple algorithm that would consist of three steps: breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Please note that we do not need arrows. We already know that the algorithm runs from top to bottom. If you grab an icon with the mouse and move it around, you will not be able to take the icon away from the diagram. The diagram will preserve its structure. If you want to relocate an icon, then first cut it and then paste it. You can copy and paste not only single icons, but also blocks of icons. DRAKON allows us to split up a diagram into its logical parts. This can be accomplished by using a silhouette. In order to turn a diagram into a silhouette, click this button in the toolbox. A silhouette consists of several small diagrams tied together. These small diagrams are called the branches of the silhouette. Let us make our plan for the day more detailed. We have three branches: breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The name of the branch is at the top. The body of the branch goes below the name. At the bottom of the branch, there is the address of the next branch. Branches run from left to right. How to add a new branch? The same way as we add an icon. Click a button in the toolbox. Right-click this horizontal line or a branch header, or press B key. You can delete the branches, even the one that contains the end icon. If the branch with the end icon is deleted accidentally, you can always add it back. If the algorithm has a question that can be answered as either yes or no, use the question icon. The exits from the question icon are not equal. The exit that goes down is good. The exit that goes to the right is bad. The rule is, the further to the right, the worse. This diagram contains an error. In order to correct this error, we need to swap the yes and no labels. Then we swap the icons that follow the question icon. Let's take another example. This one is good from the beginning. We do not need to correct it. The line that comes back from the question icon is called liana. The liana can be transferred from one place to another. To do this, first click the liana and then choose the place where you want to move it. Let's take another example that has a complex condition. The phone works only when the battery is charged and when the phone is within coverage area. Here we move the liana to the vertical line to the right. Here is another example. Success comes when we work hard or when we get lucky. Here we move the liana to the vertical line to the left. We should always try to reduce the visual noise. Redundant graphical objects make the diagram more complex and harder to read. In this example, we have several corners that do not convey any meaning. They should be removed by transferring lianas. Now the diagram has become clean and tidy. when we move the liana up, we create a cycle. Here, we lift the weight until we get tired. Note that we do at least one repetition in any case. We can change the cycle in such a way that we first check the condition and then perform the action. To accomplish this, we move the action icon to the right exit of the question icon. There is one more way to create a cycle, the for each icon. It is good for applying the same action to several objects. It can also be used to repeat an action a certain number of times. The third type of cycle is the silhouette cycle. Usually, the silhouette branches run from left to right. The address icon defines which branch to run next. If the address icon points at its own branch or at a branch to the left, then there is a silhouette cycle. With a silhouette cycle, some branches can run several times. To make the silhouette cycle more visible, put cycle marks on branch headers and addresses. When a question can be answered as either yes or no, a question icon should be used. When a question can have several answers, insert a choice icon. There are three answers to this question: apples, oranges, and bananas. An empty case icon to the right means all other answers. DRAKON is the new face of flowcharts.